Knowing the heights of the different treatment processes and the hydraulic resistances, we can draw the hydraulic line scheme. From the hydraulic line scheme, we can determine the total building height and the number of pumping steps. When pumping steps are avoided, we have to construct a high building, which is not always possible. Because the softening reactors are relatively high, we normally have a pumping step after the aeration step. Sometimes the reactors are placed below ground level to minimize energy losses, but this is of course a more expensive option. Note that in the hydraulic line scheme, the heights are indicated. Now that we know the sizes of the processes and the number of units, we can draw the main water flow scheme. This diagram indicates the number of units, the pipes, the pumps, and the valves. The number and pumps and valves should be minimum to reduce costs, but sufficient to be flexible in operation. For robustness in operation, the water treatment plant is sometimes divided into lanes. When one of the units of a lane is out of operation, the entire lane is shut down. This means that you need less valves and pipes, but the flexibility is less. Here we don't do this. Try to figure out from the scheme presented here if all operations can be done with the number of valves and pipes indicated. For example, is it possible to isolate a filter for backwashing without hampering the production of drinking water? Finally, the treatment must fit in a building. Because space can be expensive, we have to make it as efficient as possible. For example, we can place the filters side by side to save concrete in the common walls. Or we can place the aeration system on top of the clean water tank or the pumping room. Of course, we must always bear in mind that we need sufficient space for pump replacement, filter media replacement, chemical supply, etc. Now that we have the preliminary design, we can start estimating the costs, investment and operational cost, and the increase in price the consumers can expect. This can lead to a decision if this option is feasible for implementation. If this is the case, more detailed designs are needed and pilot plant research will be carried out to find out the optimal filtration velocity, the optimal filter grain and pellet size, the optimal filter and pellet bed height.